Hello and welcome again. In the last two lectures, we have done with Frederick Winslow Taylor and scientific management. And we'll be starting with Henri Fayol in this lecture. Now, few things have to be noted about the individual, the theoretician, the scholar Henri Fayol. First and foremost, the individual is coming from Europe. He is coming from a European country, that is France. So the entire literature that has been written by this individual was in the language French. Now, although the management thought has been dominated by American scholars, but here is this European scholar, here is this French scholar who has contributed very in a very big way in the development of the theory of administrative sciences, management sciences. But then again, the problem is that the world came to know about Fayol's contribution when his entire work was translated into English from French. He had written a very famous book in French language in 1916, and its translation in English came in the year 1946, and that was General and Industrial Management. Now, it took so much time for the world to come to know about the contributions of Henri Fayol. Although his contributions in at least chronologically comes first when we compare Henri Fayol with Frederick Winslow Taylor. Apart from this, one has to note that the entire theorization of Henri Fayol is based on his experience as an engineer. Henri Fayol was a mining engineer in France, and the entire theorization is the result of his experiences in the mining industry. Now, here a contrast can be generated between Henri Fayol and Frederick Winslow Taylor, at least on the point of the way in which they gained they were able to provide their theorization. Taylor gave his theorization on the basis of experimentation, the time study, motion study, so on and so forth. So you can say his theorization is based on experimentation, whereas Henri Fayol gave his theorization on the basis of experience in the mining industry. Apart from this, another peculiarity related to Henri Fayol is that his theorization is not totally focused, or not merely focused, on the production process, or you can say on the shop floor, whereas this was the reality in the case of Frederick Winslow Taylor, whose entire if not entire theorization, then major chunk of the theorization was focused on improving the productivity of the shop floor. Now, there can be an explanation regarding this difference. Obviously, a theoretician who is living in an environment, who is living in a continent where industrial revolution has already attained maturity, would not be talking about the management of the shop floor, would be talking in terms of the improvement of the entire organizational process. And that is the reality with Henri Fayol. Industrial revolution, which started in the European countries, by the time Fayol was ready with his theorization, had already attained maturity. Whereas in America, where Taylor was residing and was giving his theorization, industrial revolution was in the process of gaining maturity. So that might be one explanation for the difference in the content of the theories of these two great scholars of management and administrative sciences. Next thing that is important. Next thing that that is important is that Henri Fayol was very much inspired by two scholars. Two scholars, two European scholars, again have had a great imprint on his thought process. And these two were, the first one was Adam Smith, the father of classical economics, Adam Smith, and his views on functionalism, which more or less go in line with the idea of specialization. So this was one source of inspiration for Henri Fayol, that is Adam Smith and his views on functionalism. And the second one was another French philosopher, mathematician, Rene Descartes. We know Descartes, we have experienced Descartes through his Cartesian coordinate system, the coordinate geometry in mathematics. And Henri Fayol was inspired by the Cartesian philosophy, the same basic philosophy behind Cartesian coordinate system, the Cartesian philosophy, or sometimes referred to as mind-body dualism. We'll be talking about these two things presently. Apart from this, Fayol was a big proponent of a universal theory of administration. Universal theory of administration in the sense that he never liked the idea of making a distinction between what is called as public administration and what is called as private administration. He was a proponent of the view where he said that administration is administration, there is nothing public about it. In other words, what he's trying to say is that the tricks and tools of administration, the tricks and tools of management that are having their genesis in the private sector can be used in the public sector. Likewise, the positive points in the public sector can be equally utilized in the private sector. So a universal theory of administration can become a possibility which would be able to solve the problems of both the sector, public as well as the private. Now, the entire theorization, as I said previously, was the result of his experience in private industry. And the private industry in the area in which he worked was mining. Now, mining was a big enterprise at that point of time. Please try to remember that coal was the source of energy. Coal was required for making steam and so on and so forth. And coal has to be mined. And mining was therefore a big industry. There was a mining industry. The quality of the organizations through his experiences. So a very basic statement that has to be underlined, a very basic fact that has to be noted is that it was his experience in the mining industry which he was trying to sell, which he was trying to promote so that a universal theory of administration could be found. Now, how? Foremost, Taylor has tried to identify certain activities and functions that happen in any industrial organization. And these are the following activities and functions. The first one, technical functions, commercial functions, financial functions, security functions, accounting functions, and managerial functions. Like if you take the initials, then it would be TCFSAM, technical, commercial, financial, security, accounting, and management. These all would be the functions that are associated with any industrial organization. Now, what are technical functions? Now, technical functions would be associated with the way in which production is happening, the technology that is being used for in the production process. That would be the technical functions. Commercial functions would be related to the mercantile activities. Commercial functions would be related to buying and selling of things, buying of raw material and selling of finished products. That would be commercial functions. Financial functions would be related to the budget management, the financial administration, you can say. That would be the financial functions. Security functions would be related to the protection of men and material, the people, the human beings that are working in the organization, and the material that has been, raw material that has been procured, the security arrangements, elaborate security arrangements regarding that, that would be again financial, security functions. Accounting functions would be related to the ledger book keeping, making entries into the book that what all have been the raw material that has been procured, what has been the finished goods that have left the organization, to maintaining a record of this entire operation would be the accounting function. And the last but not the least would be the managerial functions. Managerial functions would be related to the idea of managing or handling all the other previous functions. Now, it is in this classification of functions that one can find the imprint of Adam Smith and Rene Descartes. Now, what was the thing coming from Adam Smith that inspired Fayol? Adam Smith talked about the idea called as functionalism, or you can say was a proponent of functionalism, where he said that one individual or one institution should be focusing their energies on one aspect. And because they would be focusing their energies on one aspect, what will happen? They will get specialized. In a way, the same thing is happening in the functional classification of Fayol also. People who are associated with the technical functions would be focusing more on those functions, and via that act, they would be getting more and more specialized. Likewise, the same logic would be applying for all the others, the people who are associated with the others' functions, technical, commercial, financial, security, accounting, and management. But then again, the second thinker or the second inspiration will come into picture, and that is Rene Descartes through his Cartesian philosophy, or you can say mind-body dualism. Let's in brief understand what is mind-body dualism. Rene Descartes says that mind and body are two separate things. Mind and body are not united. They are two separate things. It is the mind which controls the body. So you can say that mind is the governor and the body is the governed. The same logic Fayol utilizes in the functional classification, where he says that managerial functions or managerial activities are the mind. Managers are the minds of the organization. They are the governors of the organization, and the rest of the functions have to work or have to perform as per the wishes of the managerial functionaries. And in a way, this is correct also. It is the quality of management that determines the quality of the other functions. Take for example an organization which is making loss. Now, even though the organization is having good quality of workers, good proportion of workers, hard working people are present in the organization, the quality of raw material used, it is also a good one. So more or less the organization is having all the ingredients of becoming a successful organization. But if that organization is failing somehow, then it should be seen that what is the status in the managerial class. If the managers are changed somehow, if the managers are replaced by a new set of managers, and if after doing this the organization turns around, starts to earn profit, then definitely from where the difference has come into picture, difference has come into picture because of the quality of managers. A very good example in this regard would be the industrialist Lakshmi Nivas Mittal. Now, the style of functioning of this industrialist is that this individual takes over all those steel producing organizations, steel producing firms which are making loss, and in a span of 2 to 3 years turns all those industries and organizations, and they start making profit. Now, people working in the organization are more or less the same. The quality of raw material they use is more or less the same. And the technology, which is the contemporary one, is also the same. So where lies the difference? It is all because of the quality of management. So you can say, in a way, Fayol is right that managerial class affects all the other components or all the other functions in the organization. These two scholars have greatly influenced Henri Fayol, and to a large extent, the contributions have been in the right direction. Also, you can say. Now, Fayol does not stop at this point and goes a bit further and talks about the functions that have to be performed, the sub functions that have to be performed by the managerial class. Before going that, it is important to note that as per Fayol, management is a function. Management is an activity. Now, this means that people who are either sitting at the top of the organization, at the apex, or they are functioning at the bottom of the organization, each and everyone is acting as a manager, or each and everyone is managing some component of the job. It can be said that people who are sitting at the top of the organization, the amount of time they spend on managerial activities is considerably more in comparison to people who are working at the bottom of the organization. But then again, everyone is managing some aspect of the complete job of the organization. So Fayol wants to investigate what all are the sub functions, what all are the responsibilities that have to be undertaken under the function called as management. And Taylor says that there are five functions or five things that have to be focused upon, and they are planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling. I repeat, planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling. He gives the acronym, he used the short form POCCC, POCCC. Now, what is the detailing regarding this? Planning means to foresee. As per Fayol, the meaning of the word planning is to foresee, to anticipate what lies in the future, to make a framework for the future and to follow that framework. And more or less, he's correct. He says that industries function on not only on here and now basis, but they have also to see that what lies ahead. They have to see that what the next 25 days will bring for them, or for that matter, what next 25 years will bring for them. So this is the idea of planning. And definitely, this is the one job of the management. Management has to plan not only for today, but for 25 years from now. That is the idea of basic idea of planning. Now, the second thing is organizing. What is the meaning of organizing? Organizing means bringing together men and material, bringing together the human aspect as well as the things on which the human aspect would be working. Meaning thereby, importance has to be given both to the human aspect as well as the material aspect, because both will be coming together. One is incomplete without the other. You bring the human aspect, not provide them with the raw material, they would be sitting ideally. Likewise, you have raw material, but you are not having the human enterprise or the human resource, then what will happen? It is a sheer wastage of money. So organizing, bringing together men and material, again, the idea is for the organization to grow. This is, again, a task that has to be seen by the management. Third is commanding. Now, what is the meaning of command? Command is a statement of authority which would be initiating action and maintaining it. Obviously, raw material will not be getting converted into finished product. Somebody has to work upon it. But the precondition for that work is that somebody has to give the command that this raw material has to be made into these many products. That is the idea of commanding, initiating activity and maintaining it. Coordinating. Now, what is the meaning of coordination? What is the basic meaning, and how do we differentiate between the two words coordination and cooperation? What is cooperation? Cooperation means the intent to help. Then what is coordination? Coordination means providing timely help. Let me repeat through an example. Suppose there are two individuals, one A and B. Individual A is needs the help of individual B, and individual A calls individual B, I need your help, my friend, and I expect that you come within 30 minutes. B says that, okay, I'll be there in 30 minutes. Now, A is expecting the cooperation of B, yes, and B is willing to cooperate with A. So, on the issue of cooperation, both are clear, and B is willing to help the other. This is the idea of cooperation. But suppose for some reasons B is late and is not able to reach on time, then even though B was having all the positive intent, willingness to help A, but that entire thing is wasted because the individual was not able to reach on time. This is nothing but lack of coordination. So cooperation means help or showing the intent or will to help. Coordination means providing timely help. Now, in a big industrial organization, now if this is cooperation and coordination can create trouble between trouble for two individuals, try to imagine what would have been the scenario if it is a big organization. In big organizations, what is the basic requirements? It is coordination. For that matter, take another example. Is it not the fact that in India, problem, at least in the governmental sector, the problem is not on the point of cooperation, but it is coordination. Things are not moving in a coordinated fashion. To use another word, things are not being synchronized. So coordination is a very important aspect of industrial activity, and Fayol places a high premium on provisioning of coordination. So planning, organizing, commanding, and coordinating. Planning is related to anticipation of the future. Organizing is bringing together of men and material. Commanding is initiating action and maintaining the action. Coordination is provisioning of timely help, provisioning of resources on time. And last one, that is controlling. Now, what is the meaning of control? Now, all of you, all those who are of engineering background, what is the basic purpose of control? Control involves, or control system engineering, as there is a subject in engineering courses also, what is the purpose of that control system? Control system monitors the situation, monitors the larger system. And whenever there is a deviation from the set plan, it initiates certain actions so that course correction becomes a reality. That is the basic philosophy behind control system. In the organizations also, control system is very much required, where the purpose of the control would be that to ensure that everybody is following the plan, everybody is functioning as per the coordinated fashion. And if at all there is a deviation from the set path, if at all there is a digression from the set pattern, then initiate certain mechanisms so that course correction becomes a reality. Now, all these things, planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling, as per Fayol, are the responsibilities of the management. Now, it becomes therefore very clear that if management is performing all these functions, all these activities related to planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling in a very diligent fashion, then what will happen? The other activities, that is technical, commercial, financial, security, and accounting, they would be getting improved. In a nutshell, what will happen? This will lead to an improvement in the performance of the organization as a whole also. Now, went a step further. Fayol, first and foremost, identified all the activities in an organization, functions in an organization. He had further identified the sub-functions in an organization. He went on and gave certain principles so that the organizational management can be improved in a better way, can be performed in a better way. And those principles are called what he called as the principles of management. Regarding principles of management, information would be coming your way on the in the next video. Again, for any query or question, Facebook page address I'll be mentioning on the comment section, and you are most welcome to ask those queries. Thank you very much.